Thank you. We are now in the hottest months of summer. Heather Lake helping us protect our skin.
She's live in Solana Beach with the ingredients you need to make sure are in your sunscreen. Mm. We need to pay attention to this because I still, after all these times doing this, I don't get it.
I know.
I'm going to explain all of this to you. We are working with lasers. We're going to talk about not only sun prevention, but then if you already have, a lot of us who've lived in San Diego, we already have a lot of sun damage on our skin. How to fix it? So we've got Jacqueline here, and she is a patient getting treated for melasma. But everyone's paying attention, Dr. Melanie Palm with Art of Skin, because we want to know what is the ingredient that needs to be on the back of that label when we're going to buy sunscreen at the store.
The one ingredient.
Oh my gosh, zinc oxide, a good physical sunscreen blocking agent.
And if that's not in it, it's not working.
That or titanium dioxide, the ones that are the chemical sunscreens, the ones that you can't pronounce, like oxybenzone and avobenzone, they actually turn light into heat energy, whereas these physical blocking ones like zinc actually reflect the light, much safer for the skin.
Okay, so mamas, dadas, everybody who is wanting to make sure that they're protected from the sun, write those two down. Zinc oxide, and you said titanium oxide?
Dioxide.
Dioxide. Okay, those two things. We're going to talk about sunscreen a little bit more, but I want to talk about what on earth you are doing to Jacqueline, because I would think it's painful, and you say no. What is she doing right now?
So we're actually doing a treatment called a spectra toning treatment. This is a Q-switch laser, so we normally use it for laser tattoo removal, but it can be used at really low levels to very gently over time treat melasma. The problem with melasma, which are these brown patches that are super common in women, especially San Diego, because we're getting so much sun exposure, is that it is heat responsive. So if you do things like IPL photofacials, you can actually worsen melasma. I see a lot of patients in my clinic that have been treated elsewhere that actually have pigmentation that's gotten worse.
You have to fix it.
I know. So this is one of the ways that we do it, along with good topical regimens, which we might talk about a little bit later on.
Yeah, Jacqueline. Jane's really young, so we're seeing people even in their 20s and 30s who are having horrible sun damage. And melasma is one of those things where all of a sudden you look like, and people maybe not know what melasma is. So the bright, dark spots, a lot of women get it. They almost look like they have a mustache because it darkens right at the lip or on the forehead.
Absolutely. So most common areas, especially if you've taken a birth control pill, is on the upper lip. Mm-hmm. But common areas on the cheeks and on the forehead is really common. And it's a combination of usually female hormones, light exposure or UV exposure, and then heat and inflammation over time.
Now, this has happened really quickly. So you kind of come in. Can you leave? Are you going to be red for a few days? Because you see a lot of these patients that are getting these procedures done, and all of a sudden they can't go for like days on end. Is this something where she can go to work next?
Yeah, there's no downtime with it. And actually, my treatment threshold is just minimal redness of her skin. With melasma skin, we want to handle it with kit gloves. So this is actually no downtime procedure. It actually almost performs almost like a microdermabrasion, so skin feels better. Mm-hmm. If you've got a little bit of acne, it often improves that too. Patients love it. Your makeup sits a little bit nicer and skin looks a little glowier.
Who doesn't want that? Okay, so we are going to, in the 9 o'clock hour, I know I look a little silly with these glasses on, but they are to protect your eyes. We're going to be talking a lot about the exact things to do if you've already gotten the sunburn. The sunscreens, there's a really good spray one for your kids. I've got that one to recommend, as well as three things you can do if you've gotten a sunburn and you want to fix it for the next day. So I've got that coming up for you in the 9 o'clock hour, you guys. You feeling good?
Jacqueline?
Oh, sorry. Yes, I am.
Good. Wow. Just want to make sure. Okay. I'll send it back to